Hello, Internet. So today, after a few months, we received the Antminer L3 Plus from Bitmain. It took quite a few months from production to shipping to get over here. And today we're going to review and do the unboxing of the package so you know what comes from the factory in China. This is one of the, or it is one of the most powerful ASIC miners for the
scrypt
algorithm. You can mine Litecoin and any other coins that are supported by the
scrypt
protocol. Currently, it mines at 504 megahertz. So let's proceed with the unboxing of this unit and see what comes inside the package from the factory in China. It took actually almost 3 months since we ordered it until now. So when you open the box, it comes from the factory with what looks to be a thank you letter. Thank you for buying the Antminer L3, and it comes with a description that the Antminer comes with 4 hashing boards, and each board is powered by 2 PCIe slots. The control board uses 1 PCIe slot. You need to make sure that each one of the hashing boards that has 2 PCIe connectors is connected to only one power supply. The total consumption for this machine is 800 watts, and each one of the hashing boards uses 190 watts-ish. These are the hashing boards over here. It has 4 of them. You will have to connect a PCIe connector to each one of them. And here you have the control unit, where you will have to put an additional PCIe connector. It has fans on both sides of the unit. It has a network connection, 2 lights to indicate the operation of the units, a reset button. This miner will produce a lot of heat and a lot of noise, so you need to make sure to look to place it on a location where you have all the necessary conditions. So you need to have air conditioning, and you need to have stable power and a network connection to be able to connect the miner. When you connect this miner to the network, it's going to get an address from the DHCP server, and basically you will have to configure it using a web interface that comes with these miners. So let's move it to the location where we're going to be using this unit connected. Check the video linked on the description where I show you how to wire up 2 HP server power supply units to use it to power up these PCIe connectors. If not, you can use 1 power supply that has at least 1000 watts. And I'm going to link on the description all the power supply units that you may use to power this unit. Thank you so much for watching. I would love to see you again.